ready for this. I've been thinking about you all night long. Yeah. In the morning when I wake up, you're in my mind. I've been thinking about you all night long. Yeah. In the morning when I wake up, you're in my mind. I've been thinking about you all night long. In the morning.
We gonna attempt to do makeup. Like right now it's about 6 a.m. and I obviously have a few errands to do as I do per usual. That is just the story of my life. So anyway, I do look a little bit tired. Like sometimes I be tired all the time, you know. That is kind of like a normality for me, because I sleep very, very late and I wake up very, very early. This is stressful. I ain't even started shit. You gotta chop on your pencil.
So now, you see, it's like a cream. It's like a cream paint. And when you put the paint on it, you see, it's gonna glue to your eyelid. It's gonna be milky. Can you see the way it's milky? When I'm brushing it out, it's just smooth. Can you see that? Some people will do their own, it look like masquerade. And another thing, you know, you'll be doing 4 shade lighter. My own is not 4 shade lighter, maybe 1. I don't know who is giving you people advice. I don't know who, they don't want your glory. That's why they're advising you nonsense. But if you look at what I'm doing now, it's going to help you. It's going to bring you up, okay? Now I'm smoking out everything so that it's looking nice and delicious. Can you see I'm using my hand like a washing machine window cleaner? When you are doing your makeup, girls, boys, when you are doing your makeup, you do it in the way that you are fighting battles. You are in war. As I'm wiping this thing, I'm thinking of all the people that are going to faint when they see my makeup. Yeah. You don't just do your makeup just to be looking like Glucozade. You don't just do your makeup to be average. No. You do your makeup to slay herd. You do your makeup to slay herd. Now, this other step that I'm doing now is so that you can kill them too. It's a thing for the base. Because when you're going to put your eyeshadow, it's a good upcoming for the eyeshadow. So that when the eyeshadow is sitting on it, it says and it shouts hallelujah, and then everything is starting to pop. So if you put glitter or you put a matte or you put shimmer, everything will be speaking in tongues. Everything will be shouting. You don't do your makeup to just be looking like nonsense. No. We must do it so that we look like angels. We must do it so that somebody can see me from here to India. So this is a very, very Grace Ajinore look. You know, I love me a little bit of shadow. Like, you know, shadow is just like la 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 in my eye. Like brah brah brah. I don't know what it is. I like a little bit of shimmer on the lids sometimes, you know. Gonna put a little bit of a glitter, you know, on the lids. I love that. It's a very typical look for me, to be fair. And they're looking like sweet chicken nuggets. Really, if I'm being frank with you. This is a very typical Grace Aguilera look. So, you know, I just be packing it on because, you know, we chocolate or whatever. So sometimes it tries to act like it can't be seen. But by force and by fire, you will be seen by everybody, okay? So now I'm just putting on, you know, my cream of glory. Guys, I don't, like, a lot of my friends, yeah, would know this. Like, my closest friends know that if there's one thing that I just didn't like was my under eye, because, like, I used to have these lines on them and it would seep through my concealer and it used to just, oh my gosh, it made me feel like I didn't want to wear makeup. That's how bad it is, because it just used to it used to be so annoying. But obviously this has worked for me. I feel like you just have to kind of be careful about how much products you're putting on and stuff. I do like a bit of a light, you know, under eye. I kind of like it like that, you know what I mean? So, I just feel like it's with practice, to be honest, as well. I've managed to stop it from creasing. You know what I'm saying? Like, la, la, la. Whoa. Chiseling my nostrils so that it's now looking slender, now looking slim and succulent. Not that it wasn't looking succulent in the beginning, however, you know, we just finna slimming it down a little bit, you know. So this is the technique that I use. I do actually think that everyone's nose is very different, so, and I've actually seen a lot of people contour in very different ways. I think it's quite interesting, actually. Yeah, but this is how I do it. And then I just go and blend everything later, because right now it does look like a complete no, I'm not in your mood. But yeah, it needs to be blended. But don't worry, boo, I'm finna do it now. Like, I'm finna blend everything out. By the time it's finished, it's gonna be shapopping. So just chill, don't start getting all scared. It will be fine. But yeah, this is a Bobbi Brown stick. I don't know what shade it's in. I'm sorry. But I will put everything in the description bar below. So now I'm going to set my under eye. I don't know why it's got hair on it, but okay. So I'm going to set my under eye with a bit of powder. I think I've done it already. Yeah, it looked like I've done it already. You're going to just set it. Because to be honest, I learned this quite late, actually. I have very because of how late in the night I sleep, under my eyes is not always great, so I learned that setting powder. So always use a powder first, it's easier. My eyeliner, you gotta start with the wing. You gotta start with the wing and then now put the wing in the front. It's like a heron plane. Imagine a heron plane, but it's on your eye. And the back is the wings, the back is the nyash, the back is the wing. Okay? I swear I've done, I think I've done a tutorial on this one, but I think this one's a lot better. You gotta do the wing with love. Even till now, yeah, I feel like I'm a pro, like, eyeliner person, but I still take my time each time. Like, I don't think I could ever rush my eyeliner, ever. I still take my time. So, here, ladies, I'm just setting my eyes with translucent powder. I'm using Sasha, and I mix it with the Laura Mercier, because I just feel like Sasha's too yellow, and Laura Mercier is too white for me. Sometimes I'm a little bit, you know, I like to have like a light under eye, so I find it easy doing this kind of method. You kind of bring everything out to make it look sexy, you know what I'm saying, Derek? So I bring everything really close to my nose and my eye and everything, and I do actually use quite a lot of it, I think, but I do it in graduation. I don't just put everything there. I have to take my time with it, and I have to make sure that it's neat. You don't just do a messy, disgusting contour. No. You have to do it in a way that is clean. I've seen some people, they will just be slapping translucent, slapping powder on their eye, their nose, everything. You'll just be looking crazy. You have to use a method, okay? Carry on my life without doing this wing liner. Like, guys, I think I would actually faint if they told me that I can't do my wing liner anymore, because I just feel like I look so, like, without it, I feel like I look so tired. Like, for some reason, it just opens up my eyes, and then I literally, all I do is follow the way my eye is, because my eyes are quite slender anyway. So when I just follow the lines, it just gives me, it kind of like, it just brightens up what is already there, basically. Because my eyes are quite like that anyway. But I just accentuate it a little bit. But yeah, girl, you know, there's just some things, like some habits that we all have. And you know what's weird? I could never ever do liner before. Like, when I was like 17, 18, 19, 20, I could never do liner. So now, whether I'm like the queen of liner, I just don't understand. Anyway.
So with this look, I just wanted to put a little bit of glitter in the front of my smoky eyes. I just wanted to put a bit of, you know, I wanted to sparkle, you know. Just want to, like, you know, put it there just so that it just sparkles up my eyes, opens it up a little bit. I got this from Urban Decay. I got two of them. I will also put the information in this description bar below. Description bar below. Okay. So again, I've used the translucent powder again. I'm obsessed with it because it just mattifies everything, and it keeps things like in position. So if you've made a mistake, it's so handy. This palette is from Huda Beauty. I just want to say that I literally use this palette for everything. I use this palette for everything. I can use it for shadow. I can use it for, and there's a brown in there that I use all the time for, to go over my contour as well. I can use it for nose contour. Like, the palette is so versatile. Sometimes when you see eyeshadow, it's not necessarily just for eyeshadow. You can actually use it for other things, you know. Anyway, I used some of it on my waterline just to give it a little bit smoky something. Da-da-da-da. Nah, Shane Dirk. Put a little bit of blush on the blusher. I wanna put a blush on my cheek. Yeah, yeah. I'm an overdoer of blush. I don't care. I've always been an overdoer. My nigga, you cannot tell me that
my cheeks is not pink naturally, okay? Naturally, it is pink, all right? You don't tell me that. Like, I'm overdue, I don't care. But yeah, you can never just, you can't, like, you just can't. Like, I'm one of those people that, like, I have nothing to buy a MAC here, but I'll walk out with a blush. But yeah, I'm just going, again, I'm using the translucent just to kind of like, you know, because it just starts falling everywhere after a while. You just have to make sure that everything is solidified, glorified, sweetified. Sorry, okay, I'm going. Okay, just going over my eyebrows again because my eyebrows, for the most part, are pretty thick, but in the front, they're a little bit scanty. So if you don't fill it, it can just be looking a bit mad, like you're trying to do waves, or you're trying to do, you're trying to do, what's that thing? You're trying to do a fade. You're trying to do eyebrow fading. I'm actually not, like, it's just the way my eyebrows are set up. I try not to do too much in the front because I've already got quite thick eyebrows, so if that pencil does too much, yeah, nah, the eyebrows can be looking mad. So yeah, I just filled it in a little bit again, cause obviously just need to bring everything out, get me? Well, I'm just putting on my highlighter down my bridge of my nose because I just want to look chiseled. That's what I want to go for, so that is what I did. You don't have to do this step in it if you don't like it. But I like it, hence why I've done it. Yeah, that's it pretty much. Just trying to get the look that I like. You know, just look back and forth. I do under my eyes. Sometimes I forget this, but I've realized if you do this, your whole makeup, like, it's so weird. Just putting highlighter under your... I can't remember what that is. I'll put everything down below though. What was I going to say? Yeah, just put in a little bit of that under your eyebrow, yeah? It's like, it does a lot, but you don't actually realise it. But I always forget it. But today, I didn't. That's brilliant, isn't it? At me. So now, I'm just lining my lips up with Chestnut lip liner. I don't think I would be who I am today without Chestnut. And I want to say, in fact, let us all close our eyes and worship. God, Father, I love you so much. Thank you, Lord, for providing us with Chestnut lip liner. Our lives have never been the same since you provided Mark with such brain to bring Chestnut lip liner to our lives. And we want to thank them and we are happy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Exclusive from offer to vice.com. So I'm just putting a little bit of gloss on, you know what I mean? You know, one thing about me is I'm very, very neutral. Like, I'm a very nude person. So, you know, I'm not really into color as much. And it goes even with my clothes. I do not really wear, like, colors. I'm more into, like, nude, black and white, pretty much. So, you know, this is a cute look, you know? This is another bronzer from MAC. It's very, very pretty. It's actually orange in color, and it's only when I started editing I realized like how nice it was with this look. So yeah, you know, just put a little bit of color on that thing. Glow, mommy, will you glow? And this is my finale, the look of a goddess. And by the way, this hair is from Lore's Beauty Box. This is from LRS Beauty Box, and I shall leave all the description in the bar bar below, the description bar below. Wow. I want to thank you so much for all your support, all your love, all your well wishes. There's some of you on here that have been supporting me for the longest, since I've began my journey in the beginning. And I just want to say I love you so much, and all the blessings that you wish would surely come to pass in Jesus' name.